West Internet Cooperative Exchange. It's a peering point. It's a place where providers here in Minnesota, enterprises, content providers, can exchange internet traffic here in Minnesota, as opposed to going to Chicago or Kansas City or out to Denver, things like that. So it's nice from a couple standpoints. One is latency. So it doesn't take so long to get that traffic exchange. Second is cost. It's a co-op. As such, it's very low cost. The traffic is exchanged for free. There's a port charge, an annual port charge. But for gigabit, for example, if you're peering at a gigabit speed, there is no charge. But if it's 10 gig or 100 gig, and those ports are available, 40 gig are available on the switch to exchange traffic. So that traffic stays right here. The interesting things, and I've got a couple of handouts. I don't know if I have enough with me or not.
We'll share too.
But the interesting thing about it is there's providers on there like Amazon, like Yahoo, big content providers like that, that are providing that content. And one of the things I included on the list there was there's over 90 members that are connected to the switch thing. And I tried to break it down as far as some of the key providers on it, the key members. But what it does is it's serving a lot of the folks out in outstate Minnesota, like RadioLink Internet, Genesis Wireless, folks like that that are trying to support the broadband initiative. And again, they exchange that traffic for free. That 511 building is a primary switch location. And so, and you can see the speeds that they're connected to. But the Google is on there. Code 42, which is kind of interesting. And there are quite a few enterprises, but they tend to be smaller enterprises. I think the state of Minnesota would benefit from having a lot of the larger enterprises connect, oh, like Thomson Reuters Park, or Cargill, 3M. There would be some benefits there. You see the University of Minnesota Gigapop is on there. That includes the state of Minnesota. So through the joint powers agreement with the state is also connected and exchanging traffic there. So just kind of a highlight. And you can see the graph at the bottom that I'm just showing. I just grabbed a shot there of some recent traffic. So all told, it's about 400 gig back and forth, 220 or so each direction. So there's a lot of traffic being exchanged. SDN communications is connected, Dakota Carrier Network. So a lot of the network providers are connected. The larger network providers generally don't want to connect, is what we have found. Primarily, I think that, the consensus is on mice is that they would prefer to have to sell transit as opposed to connecting here in Minnesota. But that, I could be wrong. So I was a former board member 3 years ago. I retired, semi-retired, and that's when I started Coal Connect my company.
It's good. It's good information about that connection point and kind of education around latency and what's happening and just making people aware.
Yeah. Yeah. So, any questions?
Is mice healthy?
Yes.
It's good, solid mice.
Yes. No, and that's a very good question because it is a cooperative.
Yeah.
It's organized as a nonprofit now, officially. Mm-hmm. And in the beginning, everything was donated. Mm-hmm. The equipment, the maintenance, the work, and everything like that. Now they've started charging port fees as we built up kind of a critical mass that allowed us to start charging port fees. Mm-hmm. And so that's allowing us to buy maintenance for the equipment and things of that nature. So yes, financially, they're quite healthy. Again, it's a co-op. It's a lot of volunteer work is still done. So.
And then just one final question. How unique is mice? Are there examples like it elsewhere in the nation?
Yes. There are. The six in Seattle, for example, is the largest exchange point. But there's in Kansas City, there's in Denver, there's all sorts of these things. And again, the whole idea of the internet is traffic is